Jinny and Cuckoo. Hey there, welcome to this yet another super fun and creative Adobe Animate adventure. Today, we are going to talk about symbols in Adobe Animate. Even if you don't know a lot about the tools right now, it is fine. We will focus on few important concepts. In this video, we will learn about different types of symbols that will help us create amazing animation and interactive stuff. There are three types of symbols in Adobe Animate: graphic symbol, button symbol, and movie clip symbol. Alright, let's start with our first type of symbol, that is graphic symbol. Imagine that you're working on an animation scene. This scene is set up in a jungle and you're drawing a tree. Now, instead of redrawing the tree every time you need to, you can simply turn this tree into a graphic symbol. Once it is a graphic symbol, you can use it repeatedly in your animation. And guess what? If you want to change the color or add an extra branch, all you have to do is to update the graphic symbol once, and all the instances of that symbol will change automatically. Next up, we have button symbol. Have you ever noticed those toys that toddlers play with? The ones that light up, make sound, or character that pops out of the box when a child presses a button or tap on them. Well, a button symbol in Adobe Animate works just like those toys. Imagine you're creating a game and you want to add a really awesome start button. Now you can turn this button into a button symbol. You can give it a different look when you hover over it or press it. And the best part, you can add the symbol to your animation. It's ready to respond to your clicks and bring your game to life. And finally, we have movie clip symbol. They are like mini movies inside your animation with their own independent timeline that loops repeatedly. Let's say you're creating an animation of a bouncing ball. You turn this bouncing ball into a movie clip, you can make it bounce on its own. And since they have their own timeline, you can make them do amazing things independent of the main animation. And guess what? You can have multiple instances of the same movie clip, and they can all bounce on their own beats. Ever wondered the difference between a movie clip and a graphic symbol? You can indeed be a bit confusing when deciding whether to use a graphic symbol or a movie clip in your animation. To understand this, let's turn to our initial animation scene set up in a jungle, and we are creating a tree for our scene. Now let's place these trees side by side. One of them is a movie clip and the other one is a graphic symbol. The most obvious difference lies in the timeline. Remember, a movie clip has its own timeline, independent of the main animation, whereas the graphic symbol's timeline is linked to the main animation. So if you scrub along the timeline using your mouse, you will notice the graphic symbol moving along with the animation, while the movie clip appears static until you test or play your animation. Another notable difference is that movie clip can have multiple instances and as a result can be controlled in various ways. In contrast, a graphic symbol does not have an option to create multiple instances and offers limited ways to control. Graphic symbols are generally used for static or non-animated objects within the main animation. We hope you enjoyed this video, where we learned about graphic symbol, button symbol, and a movie clip symbol in Adobe Animate. We also briefly looked at the difference between graphic symbol and movie clip symbol. Symbols can make your animation way cooler, save time, and let you create all sort of interactive and dynamic stuff. Keep being creative and have a blast with Adobe Animate. Until next time, stay curious and keep animating. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the bell icon to stay updated with our latest video. See you next time. Until then, happy animating!